Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, I'm going to show you some new keyframe indicators available in Batch. This will allow you to quickly identify nodes with keyframe animation and expressions in the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. This video is not footage specific, and you can use your own setups to follow along. So here I have an empty batch group, and we'll start adding nodes to look at the functionality. Don't worry about media, as we're focusing on visual feedback within the batch schematic. Start off by adding a color source node into the batch schematic. This could represent a generator or even media you intend to use in your composite. Next, drag out a 2D transform node. Now before we connect the node, I'd like to point out the warning symbol on the new node. This particular node needs a node input in order to work properly. When there is an error reported with the node, you get a red triangle with a white cross telling you that there is a problem. As soon as you feed it the correct inputs, the error symbol goes away. Now double-click the 2D transform node and scale it down to 50%. You're basically changing the property of a node, but with auto key off and no keyframes applied, there are no indications on the specific node. However, enable auto key and go to frame 1. Adjust the X position to minus 400. As soon as a keyframe is set, and this can be auto or manual keyframing, a blue dot will appear to the top right of the node. Go to the last frame and adjust the X position to 400. Turn auto key off. So as long as there is at least one keyframe in any of the node's channels, you will get a blue keyframe indicator on the node. The keyframe indicator is on by default, but you can toggle Shift K to turn the indicator on or off. Now these indicators are not just for show. You can double-click on them and it'll expose all the animated curves for this specific node. What is very useful is if you used a second viewport to display the curve editor with F5, and you're just viewing the regular controls in the bottom menus, when you double-click on the keyframe indicator, the visible curve editor will update in the viewport. So Flame is aware when the curve editor is on display or not. The second type of indicator you will see on a node is a yellow dotted circle. This indicates an expression on the node. So switch back to the animation curve editor and select the Y position channel. Click the expression button. Type rand, open bracket, frame, close bracket, multiplied by 50. Generate a random value based on the current frame number and multiplied by 50. You can see the curve that has been created, and you can scrub the time bar if you want. However, look at the 2D transform node and you will see the yellow dotted indicator. It's always been possible to use keyframes and expressions in the same tools, and the indicators now tell you where your animation is being applied. Now here are a couple extra items I would like to point out. Go back to the batch node bin and drag out a recursive ops node. At first, it shows the invalid red symbol as it needs the correct inputs. Connect the output of the 2D transform node into the input of the recursive ops. This yellow symbol with the exclamation mark indicates that there is adaptive degradation on the node. Originally, this was located at the top of the node, but has been moved here to make room for the keyframe indicators. You will also get this on an action node if you enable adaptive degradation for a performance boost. This is not to be confused with the proxy workflow in the Flame products. Finally, here is some extra functionality which can complement the keyframe indicators and selected channels. Double-click on the 2D transform node and switch to the animation menu. Choose the Filter tab. These options allow you to filter curves by selection and animation. So enable Animated and Selected. Set both options to Expand and Collapse, and hide all the other folders and curves. You can obviously toggle the buttons on and off in this tab. But let's say you're in the keyframe tab and you want to filter by selection and animation. Just press the comma keyboard shortcut to filter animated channels on or off, and use the period or full stop keyboard shortcut to filter by selected channel. You can use either or both in combination. So hopefully, with this extra bit of visual feedback in the batch schematic, as well as the other usability improvements, your user experience should definitely be enhanced in Flame. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.